All right, welcome, welcome. It's time to get this next series started and done and see if we can move on to the World Series. If you weren't here last episode, we finally won our first round playoff matchup. You can see right there above my picture, we lost. We beat the Cubs in the wild card round, but lost in the NLDS. Then last year, won 101 games, lost the NLDS. So we beat that this year by beating Pittsburgh in the NLDS. So now, next up, got to play the Phillies in the league championship series while Houston takes on Minnesota in the American League. There's one huge injury. I'm not sure. I would consider it huge. Their second best player, Bryson Stott, broke his wrist in game one against the Dodgers last series, and he is out for the rest of the season. And his replacement is not that good. So we'll have to deal with a lesser player in that spot, which is always an advantage. They have some guys that can hit lefties really good. Hopefully we can get this done before Framber Valdez, who's scheduled to start game one, he starts again, because they do have some left-handed hitters, but if you can navigate around those two or three guys, then the rest of the lineup becomes a whole lot easier. So, let's look at their pitching again. Nola, Wheeler, Abel, Walker, Allard, I think Sanchez and Walker are in the bullpen. Allard we'd faced during the regular season. He gave us fits. He's their only lefty that's in the rotation right now. Sanchez, like I said, is in the bullpen. And that's good for us because we have a bunch of left-handed bats. And if we don't have to face him until later in the series, it gives us an advantage. So, anyway, I guess we should look at stats real quick and see how we're doing. Jordan Walker hitting .529 with a homer and five ribs. Arenado hitting .563 with two home runs and seven RBI. Gorman with a home run. Mason Wynn with a home run. Pitching-wise, Valdez pitched great. Painter did not. So pitching could have been better. Could have been worse. Anyway, let's get started. So start off here at home. Sunday night game. Framber Valdez, Aaron Nola, and let's get started. You know what? Let's wear these. But I want to wear my regular cap. Good, no rain. There we go. It's going to be a long day. We are going to stream this entire series. So however long it takes for us to win or lose this series, this is what we're doing. You have the sound on. Double check. I have the announcers off, I believe. No, let me check. Presentation. I guess it would be audio video. Commentary is down. Set the capture card. There we go. And on the hill in this one, Framber Valdez. Every once in a while, gets jostled around and it loses connection or whatever. Who knows?
hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
And Diggy, actually, they're a little too loud.
I really like what they've done with.
There we go.
In Philadelphia, Johan Rojas. Eddie D.
Foul, thank you.
Gets a piece and it stays alive.
Go. Down, good way to start. I will tell you that I literally woke up an hour ago, so all I've done is wake up, make coffee, have breakfast, played one game in Diamond Dynasty to get my hitting down, and I jumped on. So not fully awake, a little tired. Was up last night with the boys from the NWO. We had a doubleheader. I lost to Jimmy two blunts by seven. I was leading at half, but I lost by seven because I forgot how to call offense in the second half. I was just not myself. Had a great game defensively, and offensively after the first half, it was suspect, so very frustrating. That's foul. All right, I do not want this shift. You gotta wake up.
And now it's Alec Bohm.
Motherfucker. This is the one dude that I can't give up home runs to, and we give up three. We get him down first two batters, a walk, a flare, and a bomb. A lot of work to do. It's like playing golf. It's a whole hell of a lot easier to bogey and double bogey than it is to get a birdie. Come on! Why could he not catch that ball? Fucking defense in this game is bullshit. Son of a bitch! All because we can't catch a fucking little flare. He's standing right there. I don't know why he missed it.
And that shot makes their grip on the lead even tighter. And up to the plate is JT Real Muto. Swing a foul over the screen and back out of play. There are lots of pitches thrown in this first inning, and it's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. You can settle in. But two round trippers in this inning, the long ball was working, and the lead is now 5-0. Bottom of the first, now up for St. Louis, Brendan Donovan. Not one and out with that one. Ball one. Nolan, an all-star a season ago, 32 years old, a former first-round pick back in 2014. Pitch.
And that's a ball.
The inside edge. And it's 3-0.
All four, take your bait.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter, but he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction. And now
it's Jesus Christ. We can't catch his little flare, and this motherfucker's making Brooks Robinson plays in third base. That was smoked. Arenado can't make that play. Everything goes by him to his left or right. And he's rated higher defensively than that baby back bitch. This game is not balanced. Get under it. He didn't throw enough pitches in the first inning to begin with.
On the ground to third. Now a jump throw. Awesome. Randy Marsh steps to the plate. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So a two out knock keeps the inning alive. Here is Harper. And it's here's the pitch. Run around the goal. There's the ball. It's a stolen base. Clearly not content with the lead they're working with right now, and I like that. I don't think you can get comfortable with a five-run lead in today's game. Now they've got a good chance of adding on.
About Nola is his consistency, Bruce. I mean, we talked about his strikeout numbers and everything else, but the fact he's able to produce the way he does, start after start, makes him a valuable piece for any team he plays for.
Outside. Ball out.
That's ball two.
Why are there 22 people in my chat and only two people showing is viewing? Hey Twitch, fix your shit. Put fucking people out of views.
Two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
takes me fucking 12 pitches every at bat because these assholes foul off 10. Of course he doesn't catch it. This fucking game is garbage.
Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time to stay balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one in the center.
Castellanos off the first to two away. Foul ball still over two. Battling here as he fouls it away.
One and two.
Two.
Oh my God, this game is such absolute garbage. How does he pull that pitch? Of course he's out. Why wouldn't that go all the way through for a base hit and an RBI?
Really tough play for a third baseman and shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a
Fuck you, Nola. Down. How long is that ball going to stay in the air? Damn. That's two of these exact same balls. Oh yeah, dive for it and miss it, and it'll be an inside the park home run. Unreal.
First offering is fouled off.
Outside. That's the ball.
Hardy. Should have hammered that pitch. Like that. Fuck you.
Adios. Pelota.
We were down 6-0, guys. Chase, it can come to you. We made him throw a lot of pitches. Oh, that was the one. We were so early. I'm so tired of the fucking shift. Why are we playing a shift? Sit down. I did not set my defense shift right, so I don't know why they were playing Castellanos to hit to right field.
Number 34.
they try to get him into motion. Marsh quickly gets it back in. And it's now first and second to start the inning.
Back-to-back base hits. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands.
That's the ball.
Naylor went yard last time up.
One ball, no strike.
98 clutch kicking in. Let's go. That'll move both of them up. There we go. Could let that ball go foul. Come on, Jaywalk. Waited a little too much. Can't do a strikeout.
Nothing but curveballs so far in the at bat. Kind of makes it difficult as a hitter to know what to look for because you start wondering if they'll keep coming.
Swing a little earlier. I'm trying to let it get deep so I don't swing way out in front. Their worst outfielder is a right fielder, too. All right, full count. Walk's not the worst thing. That would bring up Gorman with the bases loaded. God damn it! Come on.
And the postseason
Fucking ball, I hate that son of a bitch. That was a bad at bat. All right, down one. Boom, and Castro, the guys that hit the home runs, both suck against righties. We can get all the way back and steal this game. We will gain more than a one-game advantage because they won't have to face Valdez again if we can win out. Stay fair! Stay fair! God damn it!
Holding on to a one-run lead here in the late stages of game one.
Phew, just got a piece of that. Just battling until he throws something up in the zone. No.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same play and do anything there.
He's off the end of the bat. Come on, Nolan. You hit lefties well. Minute, second, and third, and one out, and we couldn't get him home was just, and Walker and Gorman up just, it's going to haunt us. We got to get this run back. Need a tie game. Come on, Nolan. He is just raking in the playoffs. He came into this game hitting 563, and he's 2-for-3 with another home run. He's got three home runs in the playoffs. Norman's not fast enough. I have to hold him. Can't run for Arenado. He's our hottest bat. Who the hell would play right field? He's not much better. Newt Barr's already hit a home run. His clutch is 92, so we're not going to hit for him. We're going to hold him at third because he will be out by a mile. Well, he would have scored. Tie game. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, Tommy Two Bags. You drove in 100. We were down 6-0 after 2.5 innings. Hit him. Bases are loaded. Wilson Contreras in the gap will score 3. Nope. All right. Tied it up, though. Faster runner, and we had the lead. He's safe? How the fuck was he safe? I can't challenge. I can't challenge that?
lots of anxious fans in the ballpark right now. You can feel it.
Oh, come on. This fucking game is bullshit. If I had thrown the first and got the guy at first, that hit would have scored that guy anyway. So we were going to be down a run regardless. Yeah, they get to everything and we can't get to shit. Still don't understand the defense in this game. We almost got that. I hate to do this. But, yep. Now Naylor's clutch kicks in. Get out of fucking play. God, this fucking game. That pitch.
All sliders so far in this at bat to get ahead in the count. And that clearly shows there was a game plan in the back. That's a ball. Water edges away in second. Rick two. And that's the third out. This game is going to be number 11. Now on left field. Number 11, Victor. Turned Gun. Off at the plate now. That's ball one. One out. Ball. Outside.
Two balls, no strike.
There's Yeehaw. The
strike. 2-1.
Cannot walk him. Oh, come on, why? I hate this fucking game.
That's the ball.
Hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
Detox!
Here's the Phillies catcher, JT Realmuto.
Oh, and one.
Oh, this is a ball one strike. Ball at third, Kessler.
Yeah.
One, two.
Number 46.
We see a pretty high turnover rate because every out seems to be high pressure. This one included. We'll see if he can back up the game and get himself a save. Now you want. Ball off foul. Hey, look, we'll see how it factors in. I just can't emphasize how much that insurance run on the top of the mound means. I mean, just such a big difference mentally when you're chasing two runs instead of one.
One ball, two strikes.
And it's one and two.
The right fielder.
Number 20
ball.
Next up for the Cardinals.
Ball.
Right. That missed. That's the ball.
Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Is just one strike away.
Ball.
And the 1-2 misses to even the
two,
count.
2-2.
With ball. That turns out ball to be a really good take right there. But you don't want to end this game with a bat on your shoulder. This one popped up.
That game was a perfect example of how unbalanced this fucking game is. There's at least half a dozen hits they had where the ball just gets past us, and everything we hit, they just get to. Fucking game. You would think EA made this game. I just want to say I hate the shift. Hold on. Sorry about that. That was my wife. She got let go from her job today. Not that she did anything wrong. They're cutting back across the board, and she made too much money, so she was a casualty. But she'll get paid through July 13th, so she'll get paid to not go in. That's nice. Which will affect my streaming going forward. I have to go back to working full-time job. And that's not going to be out of here. So streams won't be nearly as frequent going forward. So we got to get this season over with, and the future of the franchise will depend on how quickly I go back to a full-time job.
The way that they can manipulate their personnel, the matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially if they're in a big series.
I don't care about this shit. Just let me pitch.
As a hitter, that can be pretty frustrating because you don't expect the pitcher to be able to make quality pitches one after another like that. Those are tough spots to do damage. I mean, a great demonstration of pitch command, and it got him a punch out that time.
Of course. Isn't it amazing how many times they hit the ball just where it goes through? And we hit the ball just where they are. Ball's not going to travel today. The wind's blowing in stiff from center field. Look over by the steakhouse sign. You can see the flags are blowing straight in. Yeah, I'm going to have to absolutely crush a ball to get it out tonight. Of course you'll catch that. He's going to catch that too. Oh, he missed it. Holy shit. Miracles never cease. Contreras is going to go three. Patient at bat.
Back here in St. Louis, on to the third inning. The batter now, JT Realmuto. Breaking ball through there, first strike. It's over two.
Yes, this is the guy.
One ball, two strikes, it down.
That's a double ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
Still 2-2 after the foul ball. To the right side. On the first. Oh. And run away at the top of the third. Now, here is Aiden Miller. And a guy there. One out, base is empty.
Two balls, no strikes.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. Is to do it, or this could get ugly.
Righty delivered. And there's a foul ball.
He's a little off front for this pitcher. That's got a ball about to foul up this ball.
Well, is that one in and remains 2-2. Not the third, no score. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing a changeup. Seems like a concert. I think if he does,
he'll get a strike. Contreras on the first. Two away now after the drop third strike. Well, classic pitch sequence in there to change the setup for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch before his offer is very competitive, and that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder.
But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table and can't make contact. That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. It's going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even though he's behind in the count.
Two outs.
Whoa, that's down.
Pitch is there, and the count's full.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there, is it? His run is the game-winning run.
Come on, boys. Got to get some offense going.
And here's the St. Louis leadoff man, Brendan Donovan.
Of course it's right, Adam. And that's going to be caught.
Up next to the Cardinals, the designated hitter,
Jesus, what a fucking waste of an inning. How can he pull a slider that's down and away?
Number
four hitter, Nolan Gorman. That one finds the zone.
Over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. He's doing that. He'd have a really good day out there.
Push the damn button. I don't know why it checked the swing. Yes, yeah.
Settles underneath it, and the inning is over. Cards leave one, still no score. All set for the start of the inning. So here's the Phillies DH, Alec Bohm.
Shocked that didn't fall for a hit. Yeah, it's going to be a long out. Maybe not. Wow, he hit it out. Oh, my gosh.
Adios, pelota.
Thought it was just a deep fly ball to the gap. He just needs a single and a double for the cycle. We win the World Series, I'm sorry, if we win the NLCS, we will play the World Series tomorrow. That pitch. I've had so many pitches on the edge that weren't called strikes.
Under it. They got it.
The first baseman.
I'll be right back. All right, sorry about that. Wife just got back home after being let go, so I had to go see her for a minute, give her a hug, and deal with that after the stream's over. Find your spot. I am missing my release point. All right, 9 outs to go. Need some more runs. Walker's 0 for 7 in the series. Just missing. Arenado has to be hitting close to 700 in the playoffs. Yeah, he's got to be hitting over 600 for sure, because he's hitting 563. Now, hitting 500 in this one, so he actually would drop. So he's hitting over 500 in the playoffs. Come on. Give me one I can drive. Just like that. That might score Gorman. It's going to be slow enough getting to the wall. We're going to send him. We need that extra run. There it is. Told you their offense loves left-handed pitching and not right-handed pitching, so we've got to jump all over these guys these next four games, this game and the next three. At least the next two, because that would be Painter and Sonny Gray. Bueller's in the bullpen. Oh, get out of here. Get out of here. Get out of here. Yes! That was a line drive rocket. Look at that. Back of the bullpen. We have tagged both of their top two starting pitchers. It's just they had a bullshit first inning last game that was the difference in that game. All right, Wilson, you need a single and a double for the cycle. That's not going to be it. All right. 9 outs to go.
But they strike for three in the inning. Two on this two. Top of inning number seven. Now, Brandon Marsh.
Got that a little too much over the middle of the plate.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Just a solid swing right there. Got it out fine. Lifted into the outfield.
Nope, 1-0. Those
always feel great.
That one too. That's gonna drop. He's too fucking slow. His job is done. Time for the bullpen for the eighth and ninth. He is not that good.
Rate goes up, and that's what he's been doing. It's been a big impact on recent games.
it across. Brendan Donovan. Next up for the Cardinals.
We will bring in Victor Scott to play left field this at bat. It's only going to be two because he's so damn slow. He's almost as slow as Arenado. This is the guy we got to get going. There we go. That'll give us a run. Come on, Nolan. No.
He's getting a little frustrated out there on the mound, getting hit around a little bit. Let's see if he can settle himself down.
Wait.
At the belt fire.
Count it 3-2.
3-2, two out, one on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Two on for the hottest hitter on the team. Come on, Nolan. Put this game out of reach. Oh, that might be it. Get back, get back. Ah, didn't hit it well enough. That's all right. Four-run lead, six outs to go. Jaywalk did his job. Sandlin pretty much has the same arsenal as Bybee, so we're just going to go back to him. They can't hit these little sliders. Get him on the splitter. Love that pitch. Two down. This little pitch. He is not good, but he's been a thorn. I think he was going to get out there and throw the ball. Shit. All right, Lars. Put this out of reach. Forgot to put Victor Scott in. That's all right. Maybe Donovan gets one more AB. Yep, that's double play.
Sometimes just executed right here.
Yep, really that nice ball went out.
And a good feed to second is the key to pulling it off.
That ball is
zone. 2-0.
2 balls, no strike.
Stupid pitch to swing at.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
Aye.
Come on, Rick.
About that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out.
Just missed. Just missed. That is if you are about a foot in that. All right, 3 outs to go and we're even. Stupid shift again keeps me from getting to a ball I should have had. I don't mind that walk. Turner's a much more dangerous hitter than Boehm is.
And that's a winner!
Alright, series is tied 1-1. Tanner Bibee pitched fucking great.
Absolutely, and that really set the tone from the beginning. Fantastic effort.
Our final line score tonight.
4 hits, no walks, only 1 run. That's what we needed. All right. Now it's on to the rookie. Rookie of the year, Andrew Painter, pitching against his former organization. Minnesota and Houston are tied 1-1 in their series. What's Arenado hitting? 560 with 3 home runs. Jeez. Dude does not want to leave. All right, Painter and Mick Abel, two of the Phillies' best pitching prospects, are going to face each other. And look at those ERAs. Abel's is 13.5, and Painter's is 10.3. This could be a bullpen game. Watch. It'll be a 1-0 game instead. Make them wear those. We will wear those. I think I'll turn the camera back on. I was pissed off earlier, so. Anybody who saw me in the NWO game last night? Yeah, I'm wearing the same clothes as last night. I literally rolled out of bed, made coffee, breakfast, and sat down and started streaming, so. We'll deal with a shower later.
Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. MLB The Show brings you the National League Championship Series. It's the St. Louis Cardinals taking on the Philadelphia Phillies. So just about set now. And on the mound for Philadelphia in this one, Mick Abel. What do you look for here?
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire...
What's up, coach? How you doing? Give me 1 second here.
It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches? Or is he...
Shout out my NWO buddy, Coach Brusso, one of the toughest guys to play against head-to-head.
But if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
Gosh, shit. Coach, did I surprise you with my... heavy running game last night? I got away from it in the second half, and that's why I lost that game. Ah! Get out of play. Catcher's not even moving. He just sat there. Yeah, I get tired of throwing picks. So I got a back that can run the ball. So there are times when you just got to grind it out. I was not interested in stats last night at all. I wanted that fucking win. Oh. Upper deck foul ball. So far out in front of that pitch. My God. This guy's got a 13 ERA. Hey, we get our little dink shot in front of the outfielder for a change. All right, Gorman. Tank shot right here. He just hit two or three home runs at Philadelphia in real life this past weekend. And he followed that up with a home run off Verlander last night. And the bullpen blew it because our baby back manager is overusing our top three bullpen arms. Party. 3-0 pitch. I should have just took it. I wasn't going to do anything with that anyway. Don't want to walk. Want to hit. Keep that inning going.
push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way. Kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Here's Molinari. Oh, pulled off. Come on, Nolan. You have been the man all playoffs. Messing me up with his off-speed shit. Carved up that at bat. That wasn't fun. All right. Let's hope the rookie has his shit today. Almost backdoored him. All right, when Harper comes up, we got to remember to change the defense to straight away and not pulled around to the right. Donnie, get there. Get on your fucking horse. Thank you. Mears, how you doing? Welcome in. Could be better. Could be worse. Trying to fight off these damn Phillies. We got E8 in the first inning of game one. Otherwise, we'd be up 2-0. And I don't want them to shift extreme right against Harper. We've given up too many base hits to left center field or left straight left field. Oh shit. They don't even have Brandon Stott in this series because he broke his wrist in the first game of the LDS against the Dodgers. Pitch walk. It's all right. All right. Uneventful first. So we came all the way back and tied that game in game one. We were down 6-0 and tied it 7-7, lost 9-7 because some ridiculous base hits that just got past our infielders and outfielders. And game two won pretty handily 5-1. Yeah. Nootbaar and Arenado are pretty much carrying this team in this round. Bibee had a four-hitter last game, pitched great. Swinging at balls. Just trying to take that to left. Oh, I pushed the button, finished the swing. That's three times in the last few innings that I pushed the button and he checks instead of swinging all the way through.
That missed. That's the ball.
Lucky we didn't get rung up there. That caught more of the zone than didn't. Could not wait. What's his durability? 78. Control's not great. Pitching clutch isn't great. We got to make him throw pitches, wear him out. That was not a good inning. Go. Go backdoor cutter. Looks like a ball to the very last second. Damn. There we go. Oh, the thing is like floating up there like a knuckleball. It's so slow. So we didn't strike out. He's already up to 44 pitches. Can't lay off that changeup.
I think I'm going to get it, and I'm still a day and a half ahead of it. Why are we shifted around to the right? The fuck is with this defense? Keep this guy off the bases. All right.
It's game three of the National League Championship Series. So now here's the Cardinals designated.
Finally got one of those.
Adios, pelota.
Now he's throwing meatballs right down the middle. We got him rattled. He was better throwing off-speed shit. That's a double play. I just want to kill that changeup. Well, we got the lead.
Squeezes it, and that'll do it. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. It's now 1-0. Back here, Citizen.
Just checking my defense because it keeps giving me a shift to the right.
Here.
I don't know how he missed. There we go.
Pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball.
The first baseman, number three.
Pitchers didn't throw it because it threw off the ball so hard in their mechanics. And they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, getting ground balls because hitters get the swing path that can lift the balls at the knees in and over the fence. This pitch is coming back in the play.
That was their first hit. It's too slow to turn two. Keep the fast guy off the bases. Just gonna let that go because I'm not gonna get there in time. The fucking bag. It hit the bag. Pitcher stops running to the bag. The first baseman has no hurry to his movements. He just stands there and watches it. This is the bullshit I talk about. This game is not balanced at all. When it wants the fucking CPU... When it wants the CPU to score, the CPU fucking scores. It's just like NCAA. It's just like Madden. What's up, Jimmy? This fucking game pisses me off to no end. Exactly. How we lost game one. Got the first two guys out. I walked Harper, no big deal. Then we get a little flare and then fucking Bohm jacks a pitch. Then we give up another flare and Castro jacks a pitch. It's like, what the fuck? How can we go from just dominating to all of a sudden can't get anybody out in the first inning? It's swinging at that goddamn changeup. You get this guy out, they'll bring in guys that throw harder.
Thank you.
That was nasty.
0-2.
Making throws is so slow. Hit him, I'll take that. Hit and run single, men at the corners. All right, and Mr. 98 clutch just came up. Ooh, that was tardy. That ball so hard. Too much over the middle of the plate.
Everything came together for him. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Those in the cage, you're just hoping you get involved. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity. Right on top. No trouble here. Hooks it away from the end. And it's one down. So the lineup flips over. And now here's the speed thread. Outfield. Toss the nail out.
Bohm can lay out, get up, and gun the guy down. Arenado dives and lays on the fucking ground. Who got suspended? I saw the one dude for, is it Pittsburgh? Well, they're banned for life because that's the rule in baseball.
This is the National League Championship Series on the show.
Tucapita Marcano.
And they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Christopher Sanchez.
Jay Groom, Andrew Salfrank, and Jose Rodriguez. Bunch of nobodies. Can't be ban. They can't suspend him for 1 year. The rule is lifetime ban. That's bullshit. If they ban them for 1 year, then put Pete Rose in the fucking Hall of Fame where he belongs. And I was not a Pete Rose fan when he was a player, but if you're gonna suspend these guys for only 1 year, then Rose needs to be in the Hall of Fame. Fuck off. Only problem with them bringing this guy in is he's a starting pitcher, so he's got a ton of durability, so he's probably going to pitch three innings. I don't know how I swung over that. In 519 in the playoffs. Yeah. I cannot lay off the changeup today. There we go. Inside out. Not going to pinch run for him. He's our best hitter, and there's already two outs, so it's kind of pointless. Arenado and Meep are our hottest hitters right now, so we can't take them out. Hoping to get at least one, if not two more innings out of Painter. I don't want to overextend our bullpen because we got two more games in Philly after this. Ah, that was a terrible swing. Fucking horrendous. That was not in the right location. Of course, it's just out of his reach because, you know, he's a gold glover. He can't move more than half a step to his left or right.
Here comes the skipper. Now, six.
And that's a big potential run out there at second as he comes in trying to keep the deficit where it is. The infielders, they've got to be thinking about keeping the ball from getting by them into the field any way they can.
Come on, God.
On four hits. You go to the top of the seventh, and here is Tommy Edwards. This is a changeup, and that's ball one.
Ball with both starters out of this ball game. It now becomes battle of the bullpens, and just seeing which manager can match up better and who's able to get to the finish line.
Bounced up the middle. Gathers.
That's it.
And throws to first.
Every time, Jimmy, every time.
Misses the mark outside the
ball, no strike.
Blasted that one into the gap, but just didn't have quite enough to clear the wall out there. Maybe a little more elevation under it, and it carries over, but that's a swing you'll be happy with every time.
Righty delivers. Just
nope,
missed.
Ball.
And he chases that ball. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. Strikeout.
Right.
Typically, that kind of fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, the hitter he's prepared for can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as the hitters in current clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss. Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle and the other way with some authority. Instead of a fire.
Up next, the Philadelphia. The catcher. Great team. Real Houston.
Cut.
0-1.
No, that's inside.
The inside. Out two balls and a strike. Bounced up the middle. Win. Passes the first. Homemade the
now pitching for the
corner of the mound to start the
number
game.
Three.
Gregory Soto.
Gregory.
Yourself that it was a very good at bat.
1-0.
In the box with one away as he takes ball one. That's
ball.
Inside. Two balls, no strikes. Donovan leads off first with one away.
Yeah.
Things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
He gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Pitch misses there. Count is built
up.
They look right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
Center field. Under it. He makes the catch, and there's two down. Cardinals four hitter, Nolan Gorman. Ball one,
one
no strikes.
Here's a run scoring opportunity. You definitely got to push something across because it's not going to get any easier.
Yeah. One ball, one strike. Two. One key now.
Ended up on the outside edge, just changing planes.
Slider down and away.
out.
Swing, and this one falls to the ground. Which is the first on the run. Two up again. Two outs, bases empty. Here's the center fielder.
Nope, ball.
Johan Roll.
Number 15.
Ball. 1-1.
That was a whole lot of bullshit. What's up, Tight Spot? Can't tell you the number of two-out bloop hits and bullshit plays that have happened this entire series, man. We have to win this game. I am not having fun. This is not fun, guys. Flip Gorman and Naylor, hoping that Naylor can come up with more guys on base.
Here in Philadelphia, Citizens Bank Park, show brings you the National League Championship Series. Just about set to go now. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Taijuan Walker.
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see
which swing at the first pitch.
He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters, it's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep those guys off balance.
Taijuan stands in now and watches strike one.
That's a ball.
Pitches outside.
One ball.
One out.
One
base
strike.
Is empty. Ball. This is inside. Ball two.
Two balls. One strike.
That one pushed to the left and foul. The 2-2.
Nice. Good location.
So now the DH spot, Jordan Walker. Out to short, Turner. Zips it across. St. Louis goes down. Now here is Gilmont Rollins. He turns on the rubber. Good luck, Warren.
Right.
And the fielding animations are not even. We've had some really shitty ones for us, and then they make just spectacular plays right and left. I just want the game to be balanced. It's like because I'm pitching on Legend that our defense can't fucking play. Oh my, come on! What the fuck? All right, that was my version of taking a lap, and I went and got a Cardinals hat. We'll change the mojo. Time for the tequila. We're mixing it this time with some apple juice, so we're just going to sip it, not take a shot.
And the hands just continue to carry through.
over to the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field. Definitely pounding him away.
That was huge.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step off and get the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty good throughout at bat coming up now.
And he deals.
That's the ball.
This is in the air down the line. And that dropped foul.
Hook
that misses the zone. Bounce full, 3-2. And that's ball.
That's all right. No harm.
That is good.
But designated hitter.
Yeah, of course he's going to get a hit. Because it's two outs, they always get RBI hits with two outs on a little blooper. By the way, both of these teams won 102 games. So the final four teams in the playoffs are the best four teams in the regular season. So tired of the garbage in this game. Honestly, I wouldn't mind getting a full-time job and just saying fuck all this. No urgency to go get the ball either. They just lay there forever.
Stay back.
Walker, a former All-Star, features a splitter, a sinker,
one ball, a four strike.
We win the series, we will be back tomorrow morning to play the World Series. We don't, I don't know when I'll do the offseason. Oh, by the way, we do have an NWO game tonight. Go click that link and follow. I'm playing 49er George tonight at 8 Central. Most likely you have Jimmy and Lou on the call. Can you throw something below my belt? Or above my belt? Everything, look at this. Everything is down, 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 down. Get something up. We have no hits, by the way. We're being no hit. Why are they shifting all the way so far? I don't want that shift.
Further, and it's 2-0. You're watching. Fourth game of the NLCS. Here's the left fielder, Brendan Donovan.
One ball. Okay. Under.
Donovan, a former Gold Glove winner, 29 years old, and he was born in Germany. On the ground right.
Of course, right at him. Why would it not be?
Two outs, bases empty.
Fuck this game.
Birds down quietly. They trail it here 2-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom four, and now the DH, Alec Bohm. And first offering is fouled off. And the right-hander deals. That one fouled off. First offering is fouled off.
Ooh, I never got to play at Citizens Bank Park in my career, just the old Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, but the crowds here are just as energetic now as they were at that old park. And trust me, as an outfielder visiting town, you're going to hear it from the fans out there in the bleachers. You know, these Cards, they're not going to be happy with the at-bats they've been having so far. They're in the back half of the game, and they're still searching for a base runner. He's been great out there on the mound, no doubt. But it's also been a disappointing performance at the plate to this point.
He's going on and on. One ball, one strike. And another ball.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Woo. Swing and a miss.
Two balls, 2 strike.
Looking sharp, just a strike away from 5 shutout innings.
Chase that jump.
2-1.
crowd has stopped.
Just one of those seam high base hits through the infield. It just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a mark.
And now, Gilmont calls it in for the out. Brandon Walsh stands in for the Phillies.
Oh,
off the plate inside. Is ball one. Huh. Swings through that
one. Ball, he's got to be pretty strike. Proud of this outing so far. Sometimes guys power coming into a ballpark like this. But these attack hitters, pitching on the road like one this is very impressive. This is going to treat to
no, the ball.
Next offering upstairs. On the ground first. Taylor wraps it to the bag. What a play. Back here in Philadelphia. And up to hit is Wilson Contreras. That one upstairs.
No,
low.
The ball.
Now 2-0.
Ball
that's
free.
Downstairs and outside.
Now in this three ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
And there's ball
four.
Ball four.
Pick your bait.
Four pitches. That's an easy walk, man. He could have
got
right there. The last one wasn't even close.
Maybe. Mason Lynn. Next up in Cardinals. He's 0-1. That one's in there. Oh, yeah.
Now, this guy's definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. It's trying to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you can find a way to close that gap, it's really important getting back into this ballpark.
Here's the 0-2. Turner with the throw to first. Now one gone at the top of the sixth. Back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis line. Now the left fielder, Brendan Donovan. And immediately comes in a strike for the left hand hitter. With the turn of run at the plate, top half of the sixth. Turner throws the first in time. And again, it's the power hitting second baseman, Nolan Gorman. Foul ball left side. And a pitch.
Speaks to that. One ball. Two strike.
Gets a piece and stays alive.
Really great change of speeds. He goes off the off speed to the fastball. And that doesn't
ball.
Know what's coming.
2-2.
Foul ball. He stays alive.
He's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit. Try to create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Now batter. That's your stop.
Turner. And he drops it down the third baseline. And he grabs it in foul ground.
Department back in 2023, Turner homered off the same pitcher twice in the same inning. Only a few players have ever done it. And this were against his former team, the Washington Nationals.
Oh. And now 2-1. 2-2 on the way. Battling here as he fouls it away. One down, base is empty. Swing and a tap. Over to first. Two up, two down.
Now that the designated hitter, Alec Bohm.
Next is the designated hitter, Alec Bohm. One for two. Good, an RBI base hit back to the first. Flips the zone, strike one. Two down, nobody up. Here at the bottom of the sixth. And a swing and a line drive and a right field. And into second easily with a two-out double.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Really good swing right there. You got a pitch that he knew.
This is fucking bullshit.
Misses.
And the count's even at two.
Oh.
And
another
ball.
One ball. Strike.
Maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
He beats
it.
He
turns
into an infield single. It was a healthy pop, but the same can be said for the contact. Not just enough of the ball to put it in play, and that's all he needed. Tough play for the defense.
Runner takes off. Oh. Pitch is low.
Hey.
And that's put him in motion, and it worked out. Now time to execute the batter's box.
And a second. And the base hit. The right fires it to the plate.
In here, leaves that one off the inside. Here goes the runner. Way inside.
Good.
And
hit.
Well, he might stay for a bit, but
the batter number seven.
Inside, and it's 3-2.
3-2.
That one
that's
misses.
Four, take your base.
So a leadoff walk. Well, he's starting to look a little gassed to me, and we'll see
he
if he can hold him in this spot.
The left fielder.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's the left fielder, Brendan Donovan.
Next to hit, Nolan Gorman. over 3 with 2 strikeouts and a ground out. Pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot. But he's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit. The tying run at the plate.
Ball two.
It's outside.
2-2.
Away a second. Step out, two. Throw it. On the move, racing back. Three games for one lead in the series.
Yeah, this is a huge win for this team. Instead of 2-2 in the series, they're comfortably now 3-1. One more win, and they take the series.
Here's another look at the numbers from this shutout victory.
Well, it takes a team effort to produce a shutout.
Welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. MLB The Show brings you the National League Championship Series. It's the St. Louis Cardinals just a little bit away from first pitch. And today's starting pitcher, Aaron Nola.
Very solid starter, is able to repeat his mechanics on a consistent basis, which allows him to move through a lineup and get deep into a ballgame.
And that's a fair ball. Around first, heading for two. And it's a double.
The first pitch for 22. God.
Here's Josh Naylor. Foul back all the way, and that's out of play. Left hand hitter waits.
Well, this team is shut out in the previous game, and I'm talk about in that hitter's meeting that's going to translate into the game and help them get on that scoreboard. So difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put them away.
Here's the Cardinals lineup now. All right, Siggy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel, the matchups, and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in big games, big series.
Here's Nolan Gorman. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Boom. Makes the catch. And now for the Phillies, Johan Rojas.
First offering in the dirt.
25 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. And this one to the extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. He's got a leadoff.
Everything came together for him. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you've got to make them pay.
Brandon
Walker
in the box now. No balls in a strike. On the ground the first. And he tips himself to the end. That's in there at the knees for a strike.
0-1 for count.
That's a ball. Hits. Run away. Run a ball. Work right here in game five.
It's flat. Ball two.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Down the line. Too far to get sprint. And that's a foul ball. Rojas. Stands at third with one gone in the end.
Three and two.
Next off. Moves down low. Now that off to the left, and it will do it again. On the ground to third. And a fast hit. That's the end. Always feels good when you come through and put your team on the board for it.
Takes an inside pitch and just delays it over there to left field.
Off down the line. There's one. So digging in, Alec Bohm. He is in for a strike. It's all along.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit those two pitches by him for all one strikes. Now back is against the wall, so we'll have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
All two. Two.
Count.
One run across in the frame so far.
I got three and two.
Great hard last spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The level of the emotion, so something to get to definitely score.
Cardinals.
Hey! So, one. Season reputations, dude. Why would you play yourself home?
ball in track.
The count 2-1.
One ball, two strikes.
Great jump right there. Really nice steal at second base. Eddie stands at second with two gone. Towards first, Parker takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom half of inning number two, and here's the veteran outfielder, Nick Castellanos.
The numbers tell us they're swinging at the first pitch more than 90% of the time. That's an extremely high number, especially when you're not getting results.
One and
two.
One ball, two strikes.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up. And that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
Right side. Off the mark, a ball, one strike. Two down. himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Back at Citizens Bank Park, now the rookie second baseman, number 84.
Jolt into that one. Great swing, nice balance and weight transfer, and he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field.
And for the second time, and that strike one. On the run, sends it over first.
Wasting no time. 2-for-2 now on the mound. And this is a triple home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Steps to the plate, grounded out his first jump. On the ground, the third. He gets there with the slide. That's it. He's safe. The ball out of time. One score. Here's Bryce Harper. Single to drove in a run his first time.
Oh, that's good.
That's a good eye there.
Not giving him a pitch to hit there. Is it a bad thing? He's dealing with a great first pitch hitter.
Outside. The Cardinals trailing by two. Not back. Winning number four.
Ball that time.
It's 2-1.
He really committed to that fastball caught at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, he gets hit hard by a power guy like this.
Hey.
That's a nice miss.
2-1.
Double play ball to second. That chance handled. Off balance.
Out.
First play beat.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground. Nice ground out.
Stolen R&R. 1-for-1 with a single so far. Grounded to third. Could be two. Off balance. Speed. There's one.
He got two.
No runs, one hit, no errors, and no one left. The bottom of inning number four now. It's the Phillies. Trey Turner.
Ball inside.
And that's ball one. Turner, an all-star a season ago. Member of the 1,000 hit club. A former first-round pick back in 2014.
That's ball three.
Misses down and away. Eddie Dean. The 2-2.
Three balls, ball. Two strikes.
In the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the end. One up, one down. Boom.
Nope, that's a ball.
Takes ball one. Ground ball to the right
that
side.
That ball is foul.
And it goes.
One strike.
Two balls and a strike. Swinging a foul. Pushed off to the right. And out the lefty.
Three and two.
What a Phillies DH, Rodolfo Castro.
Sinker's designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, put the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Now it's going to be Wilson Contreras. That first offering is fouled off. Gets nobody out at the top of the field. Hit hard and the ground is short. Rolls across the diamond. Contreras. Back here in Philadelphia. Plate number 84 on the ground, right side. Taylor, look to the pitch cover. Lead off bench set down.
Now back to the center fielder, Johan
Rojas digs in now. And he lays down a bunt. Bare hand scoop. Go to first.
He's out.
And very nicely dumped.
The bat
shot there.
No left field. Brandon.
Yeah, I think he rushed it a little bit. And when guys rush, they pop up and be bunted right back at a position player.
So digging in now for Philadelphia, Brandon Marsh. First strike. One. Harper to the plate.
Yeah.
And that's in there at the knees. Ground ball right side.
That ball fast.
Just fouled.
One ball.
Close
two
there. I count one and two.
Ball two.
Miss.
Consecutive base hits for these guys here.
Manager out of the dugout.
Now
on the mound for the Cardinals.
Number 26.
Still pretty early in the ballgame, so his bullpen has some work ahead of him. Best case scenario might be if he can come in here and get several quick outs
kind of bridged the gap that started left there. Two outs. The base runners at first and
second. Here you go.
Check swing on an 0-2. Appeal to first. No swing. Held up by Washington with the call there.
Freeze.
And this sends a strikeout. And a red. All set for the top of the sixth. And now the shortstop, Mason Wynn.
1-0.
Swing, and that's a ball.
Well, this guy's going to have to slow things down. There's no reason for him to even check swing on that pitch. He's never even close.
And a foul ball.
What?
Shortstop takes the ball. Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in. Citizens Bank Park, and here is Alec Baldwin.
Hey.
Through there for a strike.
Well, these Phillies doing a good job of putting the ball into play, and that makes things more challenging on the defensive side. The numbers tell us they're averaging more than a hit every inning, and they've only struck out twice, so they keep finding ways to put their bat on the ball.
The wind and pitch. Right-hander pitch deals.
Three.
And down on strikes he goes. Down 1-1. Here's Nicholas Castellanos. Here's the strike. Foul ball still 0-2. Bases empty, one away, here at the bottom of the sixth.
Three.
Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. And digging in for Philadelphia, Rodolfo Castro. First
ball, that's it.
And it just misses. And the righty deal. Through there for a strike. Fights it off. We'll see it up. Two outs.
Plus, misses the mark outside the zone.
His understanding of the strike zone, very impressive. That was a very close 0-2 fastball. I just don't know how you take that.
Ball two. Dodges that fastball.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Kicks and fires.
Up next,
the third base.
It's breaking in on you like that. If the spin is tight enough, it can actually tie you up.
Now here is Nolan Arenado. Castellanos pulls that one down. Two down. Two outs, bases empty. Lars Newtbar getting ready to hit. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
One ball, one strike.
Two down, nobody on. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. And a base hit.
He was all over that.
Just
a very nice approach and swing right there to use a big part of the field. Everything was on time. Stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Two outs. Hot shot to first base and he snags it down the end. Still in total command of the mound. Set for the last half of the seventh. JT Real Muto steps in. The pitch. This to center field. Edmund in position. Makes the catch for the out. And there's one down. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman.
Hey!
One finds the zone. Good ball eye one. In that spot.
One ball, one strike.
Here comes the pitch. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt.
One ball, two strikes.
Here's a high fly ball out to center. And there are two down.
Well, that's a tough play for the infielder, ranging back into the outfield. There's part of him that's saying, hey, where are you at, outfielder? Call me on. But he stayed focused and made a nice catch.
Newtbar brings it in. Back here in Philadelphia, we go to the eighth, and now the Cardinals catcher, Wilson Contreras. That first offering is fouled off. Up the middle, Trey Turner gloves it. Throw off line, he's safe, and a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
Well, it's been a struggle on offense for them in this one, so maybe that wakes them up a little bit. You know, an error can certainly give the opposing team something to get excited about. Oh, something on base, so we'll see if they can make something of it.
Swings and fouls went off.
But clearly the break was enough to get him to swing through it.
Guys, but it kicks off down. The throw is still in time. And they do get the out. Josh Naylor, next up for the Cardinals. 1-for-3. First well, pitch doesn't find the zone.
Count 1-0.
Coming up the hit.
Yo,
we'll see how it works out. kicks and deep.
One ball, two strikes.
Ball one. This one in the air. The Phillies are moving on. They're headed back to the World Series.
Well, that was bullshit. I'm done. We're going to raid out. I don't want to talk about it. I don't know when I'm doing the off season because right now I don't want to play this fucking game. So let's raid somebody and get the fuck out of here.
Chris Singleton and our great crew, thanks for watching the National League Championship Series on MLB The Show.
You know what? I'm not raiding anybody. You guys go have fun. I will catch you tonight for the NWO. Hopefully I play better and I'm in a better mood. So thank you guys for hanging out with me all day. I really do appreciate it. Sorry I couldn't play worth a shit. So we're done. I'm out of here. And you have a good rest of the day, guys.